Welcome to a lesson on parallel vectors. The goals of this video are to define parallel vectors and also to determine if given vectors are parallel. Two vectors are parallel if they are scalar multiples of one another. So we can say that if u and v are two non-zero vectors, then vector u must equal c times vector v. And if this is true, u and v are parallel. This is true in R2 and R3. Here's an illustration of several parallel vectors in R2. Notice how they're all slanted in the same direction, but they don't necessarily have to point in the same direction, and they would be scalar multiples of one another. Another important thing to notice is if we take a look at this longer blue vector and this gray unit vector, they are multiples of one another, and therefore they are parallel even though they are on top of each other or they intersect. And of course this is different from the definition of parallel lines. So if we have two parallel vectors that are also position vectors, meaning their initial point is at the origin, then they would be on top of each other as we see here, unless they point in opposite directions. Another way to express parallel vectors in component form in R2 and R3 would be as follows. If vector u expressed in component form as u1, u2 is equal to c times vector v expressed as v1, v2, then u1 would equal c times v1, and u2 would equal c times v2. The reason it's nice to express it in this way, if we want to determine if two vectors are equal to each other, we can set u1 equal to c times v1, find the value of c that makes that true, and then check to make sure that u2 is equal to c times v2. And then of course in R3 we have a similar situation, except now we not only have the x component and the y component, but we also have the z component. But again, we can pick any pair, find the value of c, and then check to make sure it holds true for the other two components. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Let's say we want to determine which of these vectors in red are parallel to vector v in blue. So if these vectors are parallel, they must be multiples of one another, or we should be able to express the given vector as c times vector v. So if the blue vector and the red vector are parallel, then the x component of this vector must be equal to -3 times c. The y component must be equal to -2 times c, and the z component must be equal to 5 times some c. So if we know that 6 must equal -3c, that would make c equal to -2. Now what we have to do is, using this value of c, make sure that it also satisfies the y and z component. Well, -2 times -2 would be +4, that checks. +5 times -2 would be -10. Therefore, this vector here is parallel to vector v. Let's go ahead and apply the same procedure. If these are parallel, then it must be equal to vector v times some constant c. So we'd have -3 times c for the x component, -2 times c for the y component, and 5 times c for the z component. Again, we can select any component to identify a possible value of c and then check it for the remaining components. Now the reason I mention that is it's going to be easier to solve for c if we use the y component this time. If -2c must equal -1, c would be equal to 1/2. Now we'll go ahead and check to make sure it satisfies the x and z component as well. Well, -3 times 1/2 would be -3/2. That checks. And then for the z component, 5 times c, or 5 times 1/2, would be 5/2. And notice how it doesn't work now, because the z component is supposed to be -5/2. So we have the wrong sign. Therefore, the value of c does not work on all three components. Therefore, the given vector and vector v are not parallel. Let's go ahead and try one more. So one more time, if this vector is parallel to vector v, it must be equal to a constant times vector v. So we'll have a -3 times c for the x component, negative 2 times c for the y, and 5c for the z component. Again, we can select any component to identify a possible value of c. Looks like using the x component would be easiest here. So here we have negative 3c must equal 2. So c would be equal to negative 2/3 if these vectors are parallel. Let's go ahead and check it. For the y component, we'd have negative 2 times negative 2/3. That would be positive 4/3. That checks. And then for the z component, we'd have 5 times negative 2/3. Well, that'd be negative 10/3, which also checks. And since c makes every component of these two vectors equal to each other, these two vectors are multiples of one another and therefore parallel. Now for this example, we used vectors in R3, but of course we could use the same process for vectors in R2 as well. I hope you found this example helpful. Thank you for watching.